Hey guys, welcome once again. Due to increasing global warming and shortage of fossil fuels, the whole world has the big question that how should we solve the problems to provide the energy to the commercial systems or industries? Well, the option is renewable energies like sun, wind, and seawater tides. If we study these resources, then we can find that solar energy is cheap and reliable from all of these. And if we try to grasp that solar energy, then surely that can power the whole system. According to Land Art Generator Initiative, if you place the solar panels in the unpopulated areas of the Sahara Desert, which gives us the area about 9 million kilometers square, then it would provide us 630 terawatts of total power. That's really a great number. And Earth's current energy consumption rate is around 17 to 18 terawatts only, including oil, gas, coal, nuclear, and hydroelectric. Just imagine this scenario, guys. Well, we use solar photovoltaic technologies majorly for energy supply. Currently, solar panels which we use have some sort of limitations like disappointing results, high tolerance, and one of the basic issues is bulkiness and where to put those panels. Like, think about it. We need the solar power, but there isn't a space for those heavy opaque panels. However, scientists have come up with an interesting design of solar panels which are transparent. Yeah, you heard me right back there. Solar panels are transparent like a thin glass sheet, and we can put them almost anywhere. In the past, people tried to make solar panels transparent by shrinking the size of components. But later on, they got that this transparency doesn't depend on the parts that we use, but the kind of light you're trying to absorb. These panels are consist of thin layer of tiny silicones called quantum dots. When sunlight hits on the traditional solar panel, it absorbs the light and produces electricity. But if we take this transparent solar panel that absorbs electromagnetic radiation in the infrared or ultraviolet region, if they absorb sunlight in these regions and allow the visible light pass through them, they would be almost invisible. It's a great technology, isn't it? But the thing is, unlike traditional solar panels, these transparent panels are not that efficient. Efficiency of the traditional solar panel is about 18 to 20%. And due to letting go of transparent lights, the transparent solar panels can give only about 5 to 7% of efficiency. However, scientists are still working to increase its efficiency. But the advantage is, we have a lot of surface area than before. I mean, we can replace all the glass-like materials with these solar panels. It can be used on buildings like skyscraper as a window, and it absorbs the sun's ultraviolet light, which are harmful for humans, and they can cause premature aging or skin cancer. So this is the one of the best advantages we can have. Also, glass used in car windows and cell phones can be replaced, and the system will come with almost infinite battery if this type of solar panels are used. We can use these devices and simultaneously charge it. As we know, the intensity of sunlight is not constant every time. It is different in morning, in afternoon, or in evening. So we also find the change in output power. And this analysis can be done by a voltage and current curve. And that is almost same for every solar panel. As we can see, at some point, we get the maximum value of current and voltage. Hence, if we multiply them, we get the power. This point is called as maximum power point. And by using some converters, we try to achieve this power point, and we can increase the solar panel's efficiency. By the way, you won't see these new transparent panels immediately in the market, because there is still a lot of work need to do. And the scientists from Ubiquitous Energy are doing a lot of work to make this dream real. And this technology will create big strides in the future for renewable energy. I hope you have liked this video, and if you did so, please hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, and finally, thanks for watching.